everyone. Welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Edupedia and I am Assistant Professor Neha Telani. Now, in TYBMS Semester 5, we have one subject, Corporate Communication and Public Relations. In that, we are going to cover three topics, that is corporate identity, corporate image and corporate reputation. So, let's start. Now, usually students have confusion in their mind that corporate identity, corporate image and corporate reputation, these all terms means the same, but they are not same. So let's understand these three topics in detail. Now, the first concept in corporate communication is corporate identity. Now, what do you mean by term corporate identity? Corporate identity means how the company wants to be perceived by public. Suppose, for example, we have company A. Now, company A wants to be perceived as a reputed company. They want that people should recognize that company A comes under the listed and reputed company. This is what company A wants to be perceived by the public. So, this is what corporate identity is. In short, corporate identity means how a company or a business present themselves to the public. If I am going to present my company in a good and in an effective manner, that will have a different impact. So, corporate identity usually comprises of three parts. Suppose that the example that I have taken of company A is, company A will be known by the corporate design, by the corporate communication, by the corporate behavior. If I am combining corporate design, corporate communication, corporate behavior of company A, this is how I want that my organization should be perceived by the public. Now, corporate design means what? Corporate design means the logo of company, the uniform of the company and corporate colors of the company. Corporate communication means the advertising the company does for the products and services, the public relation the company maintains, the information the company shares with the public, that is what corporate communication is. And corporate behavior means how the company behaves with the public. The internal and external audiences are connected with the company. So how the company follows the values, the norms, the standards, the ethics, all comes under the corporate behavior. So corporate identity is often viewed by public by combining all these three factors: corporate design, corporate communication and corporate behavior. So if company wants to be perceived by the public in a good and in an effective manner as a reputed company, so they have to consider all these three factors together. So this is what corporate identity is. The next topic is corporate image. Corporate identity means how the company wants to be perceived by public. Corporate image is the public perception about the company. A corporate image of company means image that people hold in their mind about the company, about the product, about the services. See, we usually say that this company is a good company, this company is a consumer friendly company, this company is not like providing the goods and services, the quality goods and services. This is what public image. Suppose, let's take that example only, company A. We have company A. Company A provides a quality service. This is what they have like corporate identity. But the consumer, suppose Mr. Ram, he has an image that company doesn't provide the good services. So this is what his image towards the company. So corporate image means public perception about the company. So there are different images which people may be formed about the particular company, like that company may be good company, that company is not good company. The attitude and actions of people will be as per company's image in their minds. So if I consider corporate identity, the factors of corporate identity like behavior, communication and symbols. So that will have a direct image in the consumer's mind, in the public's mind. So this is what corporate image. In short, corporate image means the public perception about the company. So this is what an example I have taken, corporate identity and corporate image. Corporate identity means company view. Company ka apne organization ki taraf kya view hai. And public view, if I consider corporate image means public view. The public holds an image for company. That company is good company, that company is not providing the quality products, that company is providing the horrible products. This is what, that is corporate image. Now, there are certain factors that affect corporate image, or there are certain elements of corporate image building. You should consider the following elements if you want to have a good corporate image. Always provide quality and reasonable price product. Always go for attractive, along with that safety of the product is also important. Give discounts, credit facilities and after sales services. Have a press relations of a company, discharge social responsibilities also, as we are responsible towards society. Have consumer service, follow the Consumer Protection Act. Have good attitude towards females and handicapped employees working in your organization. And last but not the least, the most important, go for research and development. If you want to go for some innovative or new products, then you should always go for research and development activities. These are the things we should consider if we want to have a good corporate image. And now, why good or a positive image building? The need for positive image building. If you have good image, you will have the sales will be promoted. You will earn more and more profit. The customer will be the brand loyal. Your business will expand. You will get support from the other companies also, and you will get support from financial institution. You will get support from government also. And what will be the benefits of positive image building? If you have good image in the market, you will be recognized as a consumer friendly enterprise. You will get social support and cooperation. You will have social recognition in the market. There you will gain a prestigious position in the market, and you will have a good increase in sales and profit. And last but not the least, there will be image building. You will have publicity and promotional value. Now, there are certain important measures for positive image building. Now, what are these measures you should consider for positive image building? Always give attention to consumer protection. Always give attention to the satisfaction of the customer and welfare of the customer. Give fair treatment to each and everyone. Have support towards education, towards sport and cultural activities. Maintain high level of efficiency and productivity. Introduce certain pollution control measures also, and maintain ethical climate in the organization. Now, the next term is corporate reputation. Now, corporate reputation means what? If I combine corporate image and corporate identity of an organization, I will get corporate reputation. That means it is collective assessment of corporate's past action and how they are going to treat their stakeholders. That is what we can have the corporate reputation of an organization. Usually we say that the company has not good reputation in the market. They are not providing the quality products. They are not having interaction with their stakeholders. So that is what they don't have good corporate reputation. But if the company is providing good services from past years to the customer, customers, if they are interacting well with the stakeholders from the past years. So usually we say that yes, company has a good reputation in the market. So corporate reputation means the collective assessment of corporate's past actions and ability of a company to deliver improving business result to multiple stakeholders over a time. So corporate reputation usually have like the company's financial sound. That is what a corporate reputation of certain company. They are providing good quality products. That is why they have good reputation in the market. They are they have a good quality management, or they have good management in their organization. That is why they have good reputation in the market. So the criteria of ranking depends on organization to organization, how they are providing services to the customers, how they are interacting with their stakeholders. That all justify the corporate reputation of that particular organization. Now, if you have good reputation in the market, then there are certain advantages of it. First advantage is marketing strategy. Suppose if I have good reputation, I am providing good quality products to my services, to my customers. So customers will become brand ambassadors. I don't have to go for like marketing. I don't have to go for advertising and all. The customers are going to advertise on my behalf if I have good reputation in the market. Suppose there are certain let's take an example of iPhone. iPhone, it has a good reputation in the market. So customers, what they do mouth publicity from one person to another person. They pass on like new series have arrived of iPhone series. So this is why it is possible, because iPhone has good reputation in the market. So customers are brand ambassadors of that particular mobile phone. Next advantage we have is product differentiation. If you have good reputation in the market, then the customers are going to differentiate your products with that of competitors' product. So it becomes easy for a company to survive in the market if they have good reputation. Next, if we have good reputation, we are going to get support from financial institutions, from other banks and all in the time of crisis. If we have good reputation, then your brand will be preferred your brand will be preferred that of competitors' product. Then you will attract new customers if you have good reputation. The customers, the employees will be attracted in your organization. A good reputation helps you to attract the new employees, as everyone wants to work in an organization which have good, goodwill in the market. So these are certain advantages that we have discussed. So if we have good reputation, there will be a marketing strategy, like customer will become a brand ambassador. Product will be differentiated that of competitor's product. You will get support in the time of crisis. Your brand will be preferred. Then you will attract new employees, as everyone wants to work in an organization which has good reputation in the market. So these are the points we have considered. So we have discussed corporate image, corporate reputation and corporate identity. Thank you.